today to cash, one may agree fully or one may disagree or one may agree 50-50 like Jairam Ramesh. But this subject has to be discussed now and some result. If it comes from official resolution from the government, that will be very good for this country. Sir, here it's very clear in this resolution, India is a pluralistic society. So if it is a pluralistic society, pluralistic requirements are there. India is a society consists of several cultures, several languages. So even education, behavior, everything is a different. A religion cannot be a unity in the country. If religion is uniting the country, all Christian nations should be one nation. Or Muslim nation must be one nation. We are one nation because probably what Jairam Ramesh said, not only our forefathers are the freedom fighters, even before that, the country was though divided. People moving this side to that side, Himachal to Kanyakumari, people are moving. See, my point is, so your state wants more power. That is main point. State wants more power, and I say 42nd Amendment. My friend Jairam Ramesh argues, forest, protection of wild animals, birds, education, weight and measures, because they have taken to state, you get more power. What is this? Weight and measures, this should be the change. Automatically, every machine comes and they sell it. Why do you want center power? Are you running every machines? That's a private company. See, forest. Are we not interested in forest? After all, IAS officer in Chennai transferred to Delhi, he controls the Tamil Nadu and other states. See, it doesn't require your central list. It can be go to state list. Education. Sir, education, I want to teach my children in Tamil culture. See, for example, Kerala wanted to tell their children about Onam. I wanted to tell my children about Pongal. Andhra wanted to tell their children about Sankranti. You give syllabus on science, mathematics. They will decide. Why do you take that subject to you? This is what I want to ask. And education is most important, which is creating lot of fun. Some people sitting in the Niti Aayog or some experts like Jayaraman propose something which I am not able to swallow. See, your level is different. I am an ordinary foot walker.
Very good.
You always fly. But I don't fly. See, so we want more power to the state on all these things. One, sir, Parliament has an exclusive power to make any law with respect of any matter not emerge in the concurrent list or state list, including the power of making any law to impose tax not mentioned either those lists. This binds the state to being able to legislate only on the subject emulated in the state list and the concurrent list. On the other hand, Parliament can legislate any issue except those mentioned in the state list. See, the financial power, as for the financial power, I would like to draw the attention of the House with the enforcement of the goods and service tax. We all support it. You said trade will increase, capital will come, new industry will come. What come? Only unemployment has come, public sector is sold, GST did produce anything. I think when Modi was the chief minister of Gujarat, he opposed it. I think he correctly opposed it. Jayalalitha opposed it, correctly opposed it. What happens? Today, state is starving. Center is also starving. We are not able to get enough money. Yesterday, four or five states, they said they want money. Center did not transfer money. I think Orissa also did not get money. Because the GST did not provide immediate result. after producing that? Sir, 14th Finance Commission. So I have got respect for the Constitution and Finance Commission also. But 14th Finance Commission report has recommended changes to increase fiscal autonomy to the state. The increasing devolution of central tax revenue as a percentage of total fund transfer to state from 32% to 42%. That's very good. It will allow greater flexibility to states spending the funds in accordance to with the regional needs as the people want used for funds. But what happened? However, in the years following that, there was a decline in the share of grant and increase in the state's contribution towards the expenditure on centrally sponsored schemes. Jairam ji.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what happened? I'm going back to 32%. You gave 42%. You gave other centrally sponsored schemes imposed on the state to spend on that. Further government reliance on CESS and such are considerably increased, adding a non-divisible pool tax revenue. So states are suffering. Every state is suffering. So, in fact, the transfer to the state as a percentage of gross central tax revenue has actually declined as compared to the 13th Finance Commission. Now we are waiting for the 15th Finance Commission. I don't know what it's going to do. Sir, my request to you is, please consider the state must have more power. You must respect this country is a multi-linguistic, multi-religion, multi-culture. If you respect that, the unity is more important. We are for the united India. We are for a strong state, strong municipality, strong corporation, strong panchayat. Okay. There is no difference on that.
So, thank you.
With this, I conclude.